Hi, I'm Marie-Ève, and in this video, we're going to be talking about XML conformation. Before you get into this video, I recommend that you watch the About Conformation video, which explains the general concept of conformation and metadata, as well as what goes from Storyboard Pro to the third-party animatic software and back into Storyboard Pro. In this video, we're going to be talking about more specifics regarding the XML conformation. First of all, let's see what applications support the XML format that is exported from Storyboard Pro. We have Final Cut Pro 7, which is an Apple software, and we have the Adobe Premiere software as well that will support the Final Cut Pro XML format. So what's the advantage of using the XML format for conforming your storyboard? The main thing is that it allows you to export your animated layers and conform them back. So new layers will be added inside nested clip and will be able to conform back. This is not possible with the AAF format. Let's talk about compatibility. It's important to understand that not all applications have the same features. Therefore, if features that are in Storyboard Pro may not be supported by a third-party application and vice versa, the animatic software you may use will have features that will not be supported back in Storyboard Pro. Therefore, it's important for a smooth process to follow the given guidelines. So let's look into these guidelines. First of all, the XML has to be created from a Storyboard Pro project. It cannot be any XML projects that you would export from Premiere or Final Cut Pro. It has to originally come from Storyboard Pro. Second of all, the structure of the composition, meaning the number of video tracks and order in Final Cut Pro or Premiere, needs to respect the same structure of the XML that came from Storyboard Pro in the first place. It's very important as well that all the clips that represent the panel need to be on the same track. If not, if you conform back and you have panels that are on different video tracks, they will simply be ignored and only the one main track from your application will be imported back, conformed back in Storyboard Pro. Then the metadata information has to be identical in Storyboard Pro and the application that you're using. This is actually what is used to conform back and match the right panels with the right scenes in Storyboard Pro. So it's also important when you import new images in your application to use file formats that are compatible with Storyboard Pro. So you can look up in the documentation which file formats are compatible. A lot of them are, so PNGs, JPEGs, and all that, they are compatible. And it's the same for sound files. So for example, MP3 and WAVs are file formats that are compatible with Storyboard Pro. And finally, the unknown transitions, for example, if you're using in Final Cut Pro, some transitions that do not exist in Storyboard Pro, they will be conformed back as a dissolve transition. So these are the main guidelines to be using the XML conformation to be able to create your storyboard in Storyboard Pro and then create your animatic in either Final Cut Pro 7 or Premiere and then push back these changes in Storyboard Pro.